Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. As you all know, I have started with a 5 MCQ per day series, wherein today I'm going to pick up some questions from government schemes which are important for the upcoming RBI and SEBI examination. If you have not subscribed to the channel for these daily MCQs, do subscribe to the channel and do not forget to press the bell icon and share it with as many friends as you have, because sharing increases your knowledge and does not reduce it. So without wasting any time, let's start with the session and discuss the five important schemes for today. The first question is Kusum, a scheme launched for promoting solar power production and solar farming, requires subsidies from central government and banks. Which of the following is the correct division of subsidies to be provided by the central government and banks? So Kusum scheme, which talks about or is important for solar power production and solar farming, and I've already discussed it, requires subsidies from central government and banks. What is the ratio of subsidies being provided by both central government and banks for under Kusum? The options are A, central government 60%, banks 30%, farmer provides the rest 10%. B, central government 50%, banks 40%, and farmer again pays the burden of the remaining 10%. C, central government 40%, banks 50%. D, central government 30%, banks 60%. And E, central government 40%, banks 30%, and farmer pays 30% and not 10%. If you know the answer to this question, please provide it to me in the comment section below so that I know where does your preparation stand as of now. The answer to this question is A, central government provides 60%, banks provide the remaining 30%, and farmer has to pay 10% on his own. It was launched on February 19, 2019. It was approved by Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. The purpose, as I said, to boost the production of solar power in India and provide it to farmers. Run by which ministry? This is, I believe, the most important one here. Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. A possible question can be asked from this area. It will decrease the consumption of diesel. That is going to be a normal output or an outcome of this. As I said, central government 30, banks 30, central government 60, banks 30, and the farmer is going to spend 10% on these projects. Let's jump to the second question. Which is the financing agency of RISE scheme launched by Ministry of Human Resource Development? If you provide me the, you need to provide me the full form of RISE scheme in the comment section below. I've already discussed it in the past as well in some videos. Therefore, I expect that you discuss, that you know about this RISE scheme and the related financing agency. The answer to this question is E, HEFA, Higher Education Financing Agency. The full form of RISE that I've asked you is Revitalizing Infrastructure and Systems in Education. By 2022, launched in the year 2018. This scheme was implemented under Ministry of Human Resource Development that I've just told you through the question itself. The government is going to provide low-cost funds or loans to all government higher educational institutions through a financing agency which is going to be called as Higher Education Financing Agency. So it's a non-banking financial corporation which will raise money from the market and provide it to these government higher educational institutions for their infrastructure development. Okay, let's talk about the third question. Ayushman Bharat, I believe the most confusing because there are a lot of names of Ayushman Bharat, is a centrally sponsored scheme which aims at making interventions in primary, secondary and tertiary healthcare systems. Some states of India are not implementing the scheme. This has been in news recently and therefore it becomes important. So some states have not implemented the scheme. You need to identify which state is one of those states which is implementing the scheme and not implementing the scheme. Bihar, Delhi, West Bengal, Kerala and Punjab are the options. First of all, you need to tell me the alternate or the other names of Ayushman Bharat in the comment section below. I want to see if you actually understand the Ayushman Bharat Yojana and if you've read it holistically or not. The answer to this question is A, Bihar. Bihar is a part of Ayushman Bharat, in fact. Ayushman Bharat, also called as Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. There is another name for Ayushman Bharat, please provide it to me. Launched on 23rd September 2018 at Ranchi, Jharkhand. Okay, so the launching place is also important, often asked in phase 1 if not in phase 2. comes under the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. That is something that you need to remember. Covers 50 crore poor and vulnerable people. About 50 crore people have been covered under this. There are two interrelated components of Ayushman Bharat: health and wellness centers and National Health Protection Scheme. National Health Protection Scheme, health and wellness centers. This, in fact, is the third name of Ayushman Bharat, which is normally used. There are some states and UTs which are not implementing the scheme. You need to remember the names: West Bengal, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, Telangana, Delhi, Kerala, and Punjab. Do remember these names. I am expecting a question at least in phase one from these names. The fourth question, under Prime Minister's Research Fellowship Scheme, how much minimum CGPA is required to get direct admission in PhD? Minimum CGPA under Prime Minister Research Fellowship Scheme. A very important question. The answer to this question is B, 8%. There are certain other facts which I think you should remember regarding this fellowship scheme. Number one, it comes under Ministry of Human Resource Development. Okay. Eligibility criteria to avail the benefit is you should be BTech or Integrated MTech or MSc. Only science and technology students can avail this fellowship. The institutes which are providing it presently are these, and minimum grade or CGPA is 8. Okay, so these are all the important parameters or provisions under research fellowship scheme that you need to remember. Samagra Shiksha Abhiyan, not Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, Samagra Shiksha Abhiyan subsumes the three previously centrally sponsored schemes, which among them is not included in the Abhiyan. So it subsumes three previous centrally sponsored schemes. Which one of the following is not one of them? Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, Teacher Education, National Scheme of Incentives to Girls for Secondary Education. So which do you think normally student would go for? C, because it talks about teacher education, and all three talk about higher secondary or primary education. Okay, but in fact the answer is D here. National Scheme for Girls Secondary Education is not included under Samagra Shiksha Abhiyan. Launched in May 2018, that's important, please remember it. Ministry of Human Resource Development, Department of School Education and Literacy, that's the one that's implementing the scheme. The purpose is more inclusive and more equitable education from preschool to class 12th. So covers primary, secondary, primary and secondary, and it also covers higher education. Three centrally sponsored schemes come under this: Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan and Teacher Education. Okay. So this was all for today's discussion, where we talked about 5 MCQs, and through these 5 MCQs, we talked about these 5 government schemes. The discussion on these 5 government schemes is also available in detail on the website in the blog section. So if you have not visited the blog section, do visit it. All these schemes have been covered in the blog section one by one as different blogs. Okay. If you have any doubts, if you want to say something, if you want to give any feedback, you can provide it to me in the comment section below. All the very best. Take care. Have a nice day.